I need you, oh. just have to say you two look great. You may be seated. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God, signifying unto us the mystical union between Christ and his church, which holy estate Christ ordained and beautified with his presence and his very first miracle in Cana of Galilee, and is commended by the Apostle Paul to be an honorable estate among all men. Let us reverently remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the welfare and the happiness of humankind. Our Savior has declared that a man will leave his father and mother and is joined to his wife by his apostle. He has instructed those who enter into this relationship to cherish a mutual esteem and love, to bear with each other's infirmities and weaknesses, to comfort each other in sickness, trouble, and sorrow, in honesty and industry, to provide for each other and their mutual household, to pray for and encourage each other in all things that pertain to God, and to live together as heirs of eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. This holy estate is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, soberly, and in the fear of God. With that in mind, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we have gathered here today, and we know that long before we gathered, you were already here, waiting for this moment, waiting to provide your blessing upon this marriage. So we do lift up Justin and Emily to you and their families, and we do also ask that you will bless this time and every day that follows. Amen. Justin and Emily, you have each been raised by parents whose love for God and for each other has been steadfast and growing. Their love for you has been deep and true. By standing at your side, they are giving their approval and their blessing to your marriage. With joy, they give you to each other, and in turn, they receive you into their family. They will support you in your marriage and advise you when you ask, and they will be your friends. They understand the words of Moses from Genesis chapter 2, "For this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother and shall cleave to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." For their part, please understand that Justin and Emily will honor you. They will respect the wisdom of your counsel, and they will seek to promote a harmonious and strong relationship with you. You know that you raised them in faith and in strength. You instilled in them a deep love of God, a spirit of independence, strong character, and a sense of adventure. And for that, they can never repay you. Mike and Robin, Jeff and Kathy, do you support Justin and Emily in their choice of each other? And will you encourage them to build a home marked by love, understanding, and joy? If that is true, would you answer, "We do and we will"? As Justin and Emily step into this new relationship, who gives her to be his wife?
above all, clothe yourself with love, which binds us all together in perfect harmony. And let the peace that comes from Christ rule in your hearts. For as members of one body, you are called to live in peace and always be thankful. Let the message about Christ in all its richness fill your lives. Teach and counsel each other with all the wisdom he gives. Sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs to God with thankful hearts. And whatever you do or say, do it as a representative of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks through him to God the Father.
These vows which you now share with one another are important. They are promises that you make not just for today, but for the rest of your lives. Justin, I ask if you would repeat these words after me. I, Justin, take thee, Emily, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. Emily, I'd ask if you would repeat these words after me. I, Emily, take thee, Justin, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, to honor and obey, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. Justin, what token do you give to signify your vows? If you would place it on her finger, please. And Emily, what token do you give to signify your vows? Place on this finger. The wedding ring is an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of this man and this woman in holy marriage through Jesus Christ our Lord. These rings are of a precious metal, so let your love be the most precious possession of your hearts. They are circles, unbroken, so let your love for each other be unbroken throughout your life together. If you would turn and face me, and continue pretending like you love each other. I am so thankful you don't have to pretend. By this union, by the steps that you are taking here today, you are to become one. You are to remember and keep not only these vows that you have just shared, but also every promise that you have made to each other when no one heard, except each other and God. They are tender and precious, just like these. They are sacred as the ones you have assumed here today. So I ask that you will not break even the smallest promise that you have made to each other. I would ask that you would constantly renew your vows. You may want to repeat them from time to time. Remember your anniversary. Remember your anniversary. This is a random statement. Remember your anniversary. you already know that each of you has faults. You already know that each of you will make mistakes. In the midst of those, choose forgiveness. And in addition to forgiving, also forget. Keep no record of wrong. Choose to be honest with one another always. And let every morning, be a new, fresh, and wonderful beginning. Never let a single day, not one, end with the slightest misunderstanding between you. Because if you end the day well, the day will be a good one. Enthrone Christ as the head of your home. Let him be not only your Savior, but also your Lord. Choose to develop your married life through family devotions. Pray together, with each other, and for each other, and be blessed. Would you join me in a prayer of blessing upon these two? Almighty God, look graciously, we pray, upon this man and this woman. May their lives together become a symbol of your love to this broken world, so that unity may overcome division, forgiveness may heal guilt, and joy may triumph over brokenness. Grant them wisdom and devotion, loyalty and service in all the ordering of their lives. Knit their wills together in your will and their spirits in your spirit, that their lives may be lived unto you, that they would prove what is your good and acceptable and perfect will all the days of their life. Amen. Justin and Emily, having pledged your faith in and your love to each other, and having sealed your solemn vows by the giving and receiving of rings, and looking to heaven for divine sanction, I pronounce you husband and wife in the presence of God and these witnesses, your family and your friends. You may kiss your bride. I am very pleased to introduce to you Justin and Emily Short.